very, very peculiar, as in particular. It changes all the time. The light in Lanzarote is more constant. It makes it easier. It's easier to shoot these photographs than it is to shoot in Ireland. Irish light changes very quickly. And a lot of photographers think, when they're taking a landscape, I can set up a tripod and, you know, it takes time, it's not changing. The light is changing. And when you're taking a picture of something, it's about the light. It's not about what you're taking a picture of. Like, the landscape can be there, but the light in Ireland just changes so rapidly. It goes in and out of clouds, you just don't know what's going to happen next. So you better be quick. So it's a bit of a fallacy that landscape photographers take it easy. Maybe I'll do landscapes at some stage. I was going to Lanzarote for 22 years before I actually went to Timanfea National Park, which is the volcano park, and people were astonished at this. Couldn't believe it, because it's a real photographer's paradise. But my photography paradise is what's around me, in everything that's around me. Like, I take pictures in my house before I leave to go to work. I could take a picture out the back door, in the front door, in the garden. It's what you see. And these sort of pictures, they're all around you. They're all around Lanzarote. They looked at these and they went, I know that place, but I never saw it. So it's like a reflection. It's like a visual reflection of everything that has filtered through me over the years. Going to museums, looking at painters, looking at paintings, photographers, sculptors. Any expression of art that you see, you're training your eyes to look in a different way. So these are all pictures that are very mundane around you, but they say a lot about how I see it.
Yeah, Lanzarote is probably our best-selling sun destination all year round. We've had capacity from Shannon Knock, Dublin. I mean, it has won the top destination award the last 5 or 6 years at the Irish Travel Agents Awards. And Lanzarote ticks all the boxes. It has good accommodation, good restaurants, nice walks. It's quiet, peaceful, you have some lively resorts, but you have all year round sunshine, and that's what we need in this country. Yeah, well, we're always looking for something new. We're always looking for something that has a service level to it, because with the with a lot of online bookings, we're always looking to have some little added extra, some little extra service level. Great interest in photography. It's a great destination for photography holidays, and it's really good value. So, we're delighted to be trying out something new.
And I began to see a new Lanzarote. I've lived there for 9 years, and I began to see Joe's Lanzarote, which is totally different. I would be absolutely fascinated by the fact that there will be something like, I think there's one there in Archway, right behind you, Maggie, something I saw every day, but had never seen in that way, never seen it to the eye of Joe Geoghegan. And simple, the simplicity of his work, the stairway there. I mean, what is it? It's a stairwell. But yet he has managed to make it and capture something so stunningly beautiful. And produce a photograph. The one that fascinated me probably the most at the time was this one of the zebra crossing, a crossing that I used probably almost on a daily basis, but had never seen it as Joe had seen it. The derelict half-built hotel that was quite close to my house, that everybody complains about because it's such an eyesore, because it's a half-finished hotel, who wouldn't? And yet Joe has captured something beautiful. He has the most amazing eye. I had a little joke with him recently, and I said to him, and I think James, you might appreciate this, if Bobby Balla could take photographs like Joe Geoghegan, he wouldn't need to be a photorealist painter.
There's a very well-known phrase with regard to photographers, and it's that a photograph is 1,000 words. Now, if you go look at them, there's 32,000 words up there. So you don't need many more words from Joe.